He is a scientist at the Central Pollution Control Board, CPCB. He has done his PhD in environmental sciences, specialization in environmental chemistry. His areas of research interest are application of absorption techniques for pollution control, water and wastewater treatment by physical, chemical and biological needs, methods, characterization of water, air, hazardous wastes, sludge and soil samples, soil hazardous waste management and soil reclamation. Mr. Ranganathan is a member of many prestigious organizations. He is a member of Asia Pacific Regional Environmentally Sound Technologies, Information Systems Network, Task Force, Life member of Indian Association for Air Pollution Control, member of Board of Studies for Postgraduate Courses in the Department of Environmental Sciences, PSG College of Arts and Science, Coimbatore. I welcome you, sir. I request Professor Priyanka to please hand a bouquet of appreciation from us, Dr. Ranganathan. I request Dr. Ranganathan to start his lecture.
On this occasion, I would like to make a presentation on environmental pollution effects and control. On this occasion, we will also take a pledge to save and protect the environment. What is the environment? Environment is the surrounding
which we impact.
Such surroundings are water environment, air environment, and soil environment. Suppose if you introduce any unwanted substances into the environment.
Sir, could you wait for 5 minutes? He's just said that.
Which may affect that organism either directly or indirectly, or thought the environmental pollution. So the environmental pollution based on our surroundings, it can be classified as water pollution, air pollution, and soil pollution. Out of these three major pollution, as far as my concern, water pollution is the most important one. Because water is a primary resource. Without water, no life on the earth. Even though 71% of the globe is distributed by water, we are getting only limited quantity of fresh water. That is 3% of fresh water. Out of that 3%, 2.7% is locked into the ports area, glacier ice material. So the available water is only around 0.3%. Since that 0.3% is a limited resource, that it is very important subject, water pollution is the very important subject. However, fortunately, it is a renewable and recyclable energy. It is a renewable and a recyclable energy. So it is fortunate it is happening. Next. So the fresh water we are getting only through a rain or precipitation. So all over the world, we are getting around 5 lakhs cubic kilometer of water, fresh water. Out of that 1.1 lakh is on the land and another is on the sea. So if any country is having that water 1,700 cubic meter per year per hectare, that country is called that water trust country. And if any country is around 1,000, that is water scarcity country. Then any country is having that per capita water availability around 600, that is called absolute scarcity. So this is the scenario of national water resources. So if you go to India, that India is getting 4,000 cubic kilometer per annum as a precipitation, as a rainwater. So in this one, the loss and evaporation is 2,131. So the estimated usable water resources are 1,122 cubic kilometer. So nearly surface water 690 and groundwater 432 cubic kilometer. So per capita water availability in our country It is presently it is around 1820 as per the 2001, and in 2050 it will be 1140. So in future, it will also become the water scarce and the water trust country. Next.